Thank you for joining us today as we go through a demonstration of the Quavo Fraud and Disputes Claim software, QFD for short. QFD offers a variety of solutions for fraud and disputes management. These solutions can vary from compliance and regulatory maintenance to increased cardholder satisfaction and speed to resolution through automation. QFD as a claims management solution is built to handle all claim situations, whether it is a debit or credit card, ATM transactions, ACH, check or wire, or whether it is fraud or non-fraud. All of these situations can be fully supported in the same application. QFD also integrates with multiple associations to automate the recovery process through the claims lifecycle. To begin a new claim, we can click on New in the upper left corner, then Claim, and that takes us to our account identification screen. With this screen, you can search for your cardholder by their account number or by additional customer identifiers. Once you do the account search, you're able to select the appropriate cardholder. In this case, we're going to select Mr. Wentz as he has called us to explain that he has had fraud on his account. On this next screen, you can see that QFD has the ability to pull in all accounts associated with that cardholder. This is done through a real-time call to the system of record to pull in the account information. Once the account has been identified, we can continue. At this point, we are ready to select the reason for this claim. Across the top of the user interface, we can see the case rollup, which is there to show us where we are at within the intake process and how close we are to completion. This shows that we are currently in the reason section of the process, where we can select the initial reason for this claim. We start with the broad reasons for possible claims. I made this purchase, but there is a problem and I need to dispute it. This is for our collaboration or non-fraud situations. I did not authorize this transaction, I suspect fraud, would be used for our fraud situations. Additionally, if there are any issues at an ATM, whether that is through a deposit or withdrawal on a checking account, or even a cash advanced with a credit card, you can select the ATM option. Mr. Wentz explains that he has had a tumultuous last couple of months, and he just recently moved from Pennsylvania to Indiana. Somewhere in that move, his card was lost or stolen, so we'll go ahead and select that his card was lost. You can see that QFD is going to build the question sets based on how we're answering the previous questions. So here, you can see if I changed the initial answer and said that it was a non-fraud issue, the secondary set of questions is going to be different, and it is going to follow a more traditional non-fraud flow. That could be canceled recurring, charged more than once, or even a service or merchandise issue. Going back to our original situation for this claim, Mr. Wentz said that he has fraud on his account and that he's unable to find his card. He thinks it might be lost. Once our reason is selected, we can continue forward. On the next screen, we will select the transaction or transactions that we want to dispute. QFD will make a real-time call to the system of record in order to pull all of the transactions back for review. You'll notice that this includes debits, credits, and pending transactions. QFD has the availability and opportunity to pull back pending transactions to include those in our claims. This functionality does a couple of things that are a great benefit. First and foremost, from a cardholder standpoint, the ability to be able to file a claim on the initial interaction with the financial institution is a huge win. The second benefit of including pending transactions is the single call resolution for the cardholder. This is a great win for the financial institution as well as the customer. Without the ability to file claims on the pending transactions, financial institutions would be directing the cardholders to call back. That would then increase call volume while also being an unpleasant experience for their cardholders. QFD is able to solve for this issue. Returning to our case, we are going to select the transactions for $43.05 and $48.69 as the fraudulent transactions that occurred on Mr. Wentz's account. Once we have our transactions selected, we can continue forward with the case. You will now see at the top of the screen, we are in the detailed portion of the claim, where we will get into the finer details of this case. Across the top, you'll notice that it reiterates the case type or reason type for this claim. In this case, it is that Mr. Wentz said his card was lost. We are now going to start gathering the details of the case, the when, where, and how of that card being lost. The system will ask when Mr. Wentz lost his card. The agent can select a date from the provided calendar. Next, we're going to ask where the card was lost. There is a preloaded list of possible locations that it was lost, or the agent can say that it is unknown and put in additional information in the areas provided. The system will also ask if anything else was lost. If we say yes, a freeform box appears to allow the agent to add additional information regarding the items lost. If we say no, we're able to move forward with the case. In this example, we will notate that Mr. Wentz also lost his driver's license and $400 cash. For the next step, it will display a disclosure that says, "Due to the fraud on your account, we are going to block your card." You will notice that is not a question. QFD is built to minimize the fraud risk to both the financial institution and the cardholder by blocking the compromised card. QFD has the ability to connect to the system of record and ensure that the card in question is getting closed down due to fraud. The next question we do cover is whether they would like us to reissue a card or not. Again, with that connection to the system of record, not only can we block the card, but we can have the card reordered for the cardholder automatically. If they say no here, you'll notice it provides a disclosure on what steps can be taken and how the cardholder can receive a card in the future if they would like. If we say yes, QFD does have the ability to account for any fees associated with a card reorder. Those fees could come from any shipping or handling associated with rushing the card, or potentially a reorder fee associated with the card. QFD can be integrated with your system of record to account for those fees and ensure that they are being automatically charged as necessary. In this example, we will go ahead and send it out to Mr. Wentz standard mail as he wants to receive his card within the next 7 to 10 business days. As we complete the claim questionnaire, we can continue forward to the summary screen. As you'll see at the top of the screen, we've reached our last step in the claims intake process, the summary screen. This screen allows us to do two things prior to completing the intake of this case. First, we can review the disputed transactions as well as the total aggregated amount of the claim and confirm that with the cardholder. This gives us a chance to ensure that all disputed transactions are accounted for and in the case. If we need to add any additional transactions, we can go back and do so now. Secondly, we are able to confirm the correspondence channel through which we're going to be communicating with this cardholder through the duration of this case. QFD is built to be able to handle email and mail correspondence channels. Email is the preferred method of communication, and QFD is able to ensure that we are staying compliant with any opt-in or e-verify steps needed to ensure the cardholder can receive emails. If not, QFD will send the letter for the client to ensure that they are staying compliant with the regulatory requirements around communication in both Reg E and Reg Z claims. At this point, we're ready to submit this case and get our confirmation on this submission. We've arrived at our confirmation screen, and you'll notice at the top of the screen the confirmation number, which is the cardholder's claim number that can be used to identify their case in the future. In the middle portion, we have verbiage which we will share with the cardholder confirming the disputed transactions and amounts. Lastly, we have the key portion here under the What Happens Next section. This section will cover any key points that have been decided so far on the claim. This is truly one of the first automated steps within QFD. Through our initial interaction decision, we can set thresholds for when claims will receive an automatic final credit, a provisional credit, or which cases would need to be reviewed prior to any credits going to the account. We can set these thresholds based on a myriad of criteria. We can look at claim type and product type. We can review potential claim abuse as well as determine dollar amounts in the claims. We can even look at the relationship the cardholder has with their financial institution. All of this to help us determine whether or not this would be a fit for a provisional credit. Each of these thresholds can be individually set based on the risk appetite of each of our clients versus the cardholder satisfaction that they are looking for. Again, keep in mind this is also a letter that's going to be sent out to our cardholder. Here in the bottom right-hand corner of the screen, we can see the PDF version of this letter that is a mere copy of what our cardholders are going to receive. This completes the intake portion of this case. In addition to traditional intake methods such as call centers and visiting the banking centers, QFD can be integrated with your online banking and mobile banking platforms to allow for self-service intake for your cardholders. In this example, we see the cardholder logging into their online banking portal. In these portals, QFD can be embedded in a variety of ways. As you can see, we can embed the dispute option with the individual transactions, so as a cardholder sees a transaction they would like to dispute, they simply click on the transaction to move it forward. Additionally, we can embed a specific link into the online or mobile platform to allow for cardholders to dispute transactions as needed in a more general fashion. As they click on the link, the cardholder is then brought into the QFD software in a seamless transition so that it appears they're still within their online portal. As they go through the intake questionnaire, you'll notice that it is the exact same questionnaire and experience that they would be receiving whether they go through online or mobile, calling into a call center, or were to visit a local banking center. With QFD, it really is a seamless process regardless of the intake channel that they choose. You will notice that as the cardholder progresses, the exact same questions are asked. The cardholder has the exact same summary screen at the end of intake to confirm both the transactions in dispute and the communication channel they will be using. Lastly, the confirmation screen they see is the exact same confirmation they would receive had they called in. The flexibility of intake within QFD makes it easy for your cardholders to communicate with you in their preferred method to dispute any transactions as needed.